Sir William Lawrence Bragg, the 31st of March 1890 to the 1st of July 1971, was an Australian-born British physicist and X-ray crystallographer, discoverer, 1912, of Bragg's law of X-ray diffraction, which is basic for the determination of crystal structure. He was joint recipient, with his father, William Henry Bragg, of the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1915, for their services in the analysis of crystal structure by means of X-rays, an important step in the development of X-ray crystallography. Bragg was knighted in 1941. As of 2020, he is the youngest ever Nobel laureate in physics, having received the award at the age of 25 years. Bragg was the director of the Cavendish Laboratory, Cambridge, when the discovery of the structure of DNA was reported by James D. Watson and Francis Crick in February 1953. Bragg was born in Adelaide, South Australia to Sir William Henry Bragg, 1862-1942, elder professor of mathematics and physics at the University of Adelaide, and Gwendolyn, 1869-1929, daughter of Sir Charles Todd, government astronomer of South Australia. He showed an early interest in science and mathematics. Shortly after starting school, he fell from his tricycle and broke his arm. His father, who had read about Röntgen's experiments in Europe and was performing his own experiments, used the newly discovered X-rays and his experimental equipment to examine the broken arm. This is the first recorded surgical use of X-rays in Australia. In 1900, Bragg was a student at Queen's School, North Adelaide, followed by 5 years at St. Peter's College, Adelaide. He went to the University of Adelaide at the age of 16 to study mathematics, chemistry and physics, graduating in 1908. In the same year, his father accepted the Cavendish Chair of Physics at the University of Leeds, and brought the family to England. Bragg entered Trinity College, Cambridge in the autumn of 1909 and received a major scholarship in mathematics, despite taking the exam while in bed with pneumonia. After initially excelling in mathematics, he transferred to the physics course in the later years of his studies, and graduated with first-class honors in 1911. In 1914, Bragg was elected to a fellowship at Trinity College. A fellowship at a Cambridge college involves the submission and defense of a thesis. Among Bragg's other interests was shell collecting. His personal collection amounted to specimens from some 500 species, all personally collected from South Australia. He discovered a new species of cuttlefish, Sepia braggi, named for him by Joseph Verco. X-rays and the Bragg equation. The composition of X-rays was unknown. His father argued that X-rays are streams of particles, others argued that they are waves. Max von Laue directed an X-ray beam at a crystal in front of a photographic plate. Alongside of the spot where the beam struck, there were additional spots from deflected rays, hence X-rays are waves. In 1912, as a first-year research student at Cambridge, W. L. Bragg, while strolling by the river, had the insight that crystals made from parallel sheets of atoms would not diffract X-ray beams that struck their surface at most angles because X-rays deflected by collisions with atoms would be out of phase, canceling one another out. However, when the X-ray beam stuck at an angle at which the distances it passed between atomic sheets in the crystal equaled the X-ray's wavelength, then those deflected would be in phase and produce a spot on a nearby film. From this insight, he wrote the simple Bragg equation that relates the wavelength of the X-ray and the distance between atomic sheets in a simple crystal to the angles at which an impinging X-ray beam would be reflected. His father built an apparatus in which a crystal could be rotated to precise angles while measuring the energy of reflections. This enabled father and son to measure the distances between the atomic sheets in a number of simple crystals. They calculated the spacing of the atoms from the weight of the crystal and the Avogadro constant, which enabled them to measure the wavelengths of the X-rays produced by different metallic targets in the X-ray tubes. W. H. Bragg reported their results at meetings and in a paper, giving credit to his son, unnamed, for the equation, but not as a co-author, which gave his son some heartaches, which he never overcame. Work on sound ranging. Bragg was commissioned early in World War I in the Royal Horse Artillery as a second lieutenant of the Leicestershire Battery. In 1915, he was seconded to the Royal Engineers to develop a method to localize enemy artillery from the boom of their firing. On the 2nd of September 1915, his brother was killed during the Gallipoli campaign. Shortly afterwards, he and his father were awarded the Nobel Prize in Physics. He was 25 years old and remains the youngest science laureate. The problem with sound ranging was that the heavy guns boomed at too low a frequency to be detected by a microphone. After months of frustrating failure, he and his group devised a hot wire airwave detector that solved the problem. In this work, he was aided by Charles Galton Darwin, William Sansom Tucker, Harold Roper Robinson, Edward Andrade and Henry Harold Hemming. British sound ranging was very effective. There was a unit in every British army and their system was adopted by the Americans when they entered the war. For his work during the war, he was awarded the Military Cross and appointed officer of the Order of the British Empire. He was also mentioned in dispatches on the 16th of June 1916, the 4th of January 1917 and the 7th of July 1919. Hot wire sound ranging was used in World War II, during which he served as a civilian advisor. Between the wars, from 1919 to 1937, he worked at the Victoria University of Manchester as Langworthy Professor of Physics. He became the director of the National Physical Laboratory in Teddington in 1937. After World War II, Bragg returned to Cambridge, splitting the Cavendish Laboratory into research groups. He believed that the ideal research unit is one of 6 to 12 scientists and a few assistants.